Hey there, science explorers! It's Justin again, and welcome to my backyard. Today, Mia and I are gearing up for a super exciting adventure right here at home. Since we're going to be making a nature documentary, we've gathered some supplies, like some video cameras, a camera to take pictures, microphones, and we even got a tiny video camera that attaches to Mia's hat for recording hands-free. And look! Mia and some of her friends are going to be our camera crew. They'll be filming all of our adventures. And lastly, I of course have my lab coat and notebook. Since we're learning to be scientists, I want to look the part. This notebook is where I'm going to record interesting facts, save pictures, and make a record of everything we learn along the way. I think you should have some field notes pages too. Follow along with those as we explore today. We're going to observe and discover all the amazing life that's hiding in plain sight. Who knows what tiny creatures and cool plants we might find. This will be great practice for when we go out and explore bigger places. So, let's go! Since we're close to a tree, let's start there. I bet there are some cool things to see. Ooh, we were right. Look at this. So many bugs hang out on this tree. And birds too. Wait a minute. How did life scientists actually do this? It's not just about seeing cool stuff, right? Oh, right. Scientists ask questions about what they see. They really think about why things are the way they are and how everything works together in nature. So if we're going to be like scientists, we need to start asking our own questions. Like, why are the tree leaves this color? Or what does the tree need to grow so big and tall? And these insects, what are they doing here on this tree? Do they eat the leaves, or maybe they're hiding from bigger animals? We're thinking more like scientists already. Ooh, let's head over to the flower garden next. What are some questions we might be able to ask about the flowers there? Look for the pause button in your field notes and write down your ideas or questions you might have about flowers. Wow, look at this flower, Mia. It's the most beautiful flower in the world. And it smells the best too. Oh, scientists don't make observations like that? Well, why not? It's an opinion? Oh, so a fact is something that's true for everyone, such as this flower has petals, because we can all agree it has petals. But saying it's the most beautiful is just my opinion, which can be different for everyone. And look at this bee. I think it's here because it loves this flower more than any other plant around. Wait, so saying the bee loves it here is also just my guess? We need real evidence or proof to make it a fact? Got it, Mia. To be a good scientist, I have to be careful to say what I know is true for sure, and not what's just my idea. We need facts, not just opinions, to really understand things. But what do scientists do when they have an idea, but they don't know the facts yet? Oh, I get it. They do research. They study more about their ideas, maybe read what other scientists have discovered, and then they experiment. Scientists set up experiments to test their ideas. Like, if we want to know why the bee likes the flower, we could watch it every day. See what it does, and maybe even see what happens if it doesn't have this flower bush around. Scientists also keep track of what happens, recording every little detail, so they can learn if their idea is right or not. It's all about finding the truth. Shh, Mia, look up there. A bird's nest with chicks. Let's get a little closer. Oh, you're right. We need to be careful not to disturb them. Scientists always make sure their observations don't harm nature. We can use tools like binoculars or our cameras to zoom in and see more without getting too close. This way, we respect the wildlife space and ensure they feel safe in their home. We can watch and learn a lot from here without interfering. There are lots of places you can go to explore safely without harming any animals or other wildlife. Places like parks, zoos, and nature reserves are perfect for observing different types of wildlife. Each location is prepared for visitors and helps protect the animals in it at the same time. Ooh, right, Mia. These places also have paths and signs to help us stay in the right area so we don't accidentally disturb any habitats. Wow, we learned so much today about being real scientists and observing nature the right way. We made some discoveries, but more importantly, we explored and made observations without disturbing our wildlife friends. We're putting our observations together in a documentary, but that can't be the only way that scientists share their discoveries. So, I wonder what other ways there are to get new information and discoveries out to the world. Let's find that out next time. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey, hey.